Wentz is back again. Wentz looking, looking, still looking. He is going deep down the far side, and it is caught! And in for the touchdown goes Mac Hollins! Mac Hollins got loose on the far side, and Wentz threw it 64 yards!
Joining us again here in Tape Study is Eagles quarterbacks coach John DeFilippo. Coach, first of all, congratulations. Another big win. Certainly getting used to saying that and feel good about that.
Absolutely.
Well, the talk around the league and the city of Philadelphia is the play of your quarterback, Carson Wentz, and he had another good game, four touchdowns here. Now, talk about this play. This play comes after a big sack, sort of puts you behind the chains, but he's able to make something work here.
Well, the first thing we knew is a couple things. We knew the Redskins like to play what we call middle of the field open on second and long. So if there's a single safety middle here, we call that middle of the field closed. Middle of the field open means that there's two safeties. So we're calling this route for middle of the field open. So we knew on second and extra long, there was a good chance the Redskins were going to be in middle of the field open. We have three types of reads for the quarterback. We have pure progression reads, which are literally no matter what the coverage is, 1 to 2 to 3. We have a single high, two high reads. Literally, we're reading one side of the field. If it's too high, another side of the field if it's single safety middle. And then we have what we call levels throws, okay? Levels throws is an example of this play right here. We're going to have a man high, a man in the middle, and a man low. So what you're going to see right now is Mac Hollins work vertical with speed, okay, what we call a circle post. So he's going to run 15 yards, lean to the outside, and then the quarterback in a perfect world wants to throw him right on this near hash. Unless the corner's outside, then he's going to bring him down the field a little bit more. Alshon's going to get into the wake. When we say get into the wake, we mean get right into the wake of where Mac Hollins is, okay, and he's going to run a 12-yard corner. The key to this play is protection, okay? Protection, protection, protection whenever you're throwing the ball down the field. So you're going to see Trey Burton chip to the flat, okay? You're going to see the running back here chip to the flat. And then just in case the quarterback doesn't like the ball down the field, we're going to have Zach Ertz running what we call a 12-yard basic cross right here. So again, we talked about a levels throw. We have a man high, we have a man in the middle, and we have a man low. We saw DJ Swearinger. Again, ball stayed middle of the field open. DJ Swearinger, we're reading depth, width, and hips of that safety right here. He's getting deep. He's not getting width, okay, and his hips are towards the sideline. So if we say 2 out of 3, if he's not getting deep, if his hips are to the sideline, or he's not getting any width, we're going to cut that ball loose to the deep ball right there.
Clean pocket. You brought that up. Able to hit Mac Hollins right in stride. Great job with a young fella catching it there. Let's take a look at a play here. This guy, I don't know if there's a tight end in the game playing better than Zach Ertz right now.
He's playing great, and I've been fortunate enough in my 11-year NFL career to be around a lot of really good tight ends. This player, Zach Ertz, understands leverage more than any player I've ever been around, whether it be a receiver, whether it be a running back, whether it be a tight end. He just understands leverage and understands how to set defenders up. What we're trying to accomplish here is a couple things. We're trying to get speed down the middle of the field here with Nelson Aguilar. Obviously, he's one of the fastest guys in the league. We have a dagger route here by Mac Hollins. The first thing the quarterback is looking for is whether it's going to be man or zone on this side of the field. Alshon Jeffery is going to be running what we call a shallow cross right here. The quarterback is keying, number one, the corner, number two, the safety. We knew a couple things. They will cut the shallow cross route with either the corner or the safety. So if Carson right now sees the corner go, we're going to go throw a big alert to Ertz here, which where he's running a deep cross. If we feel the safety come out of the middle field here, he's cutting them, we're going to alert the deep cross. So as you can see, as the play goes along, they end up blitzing Swearinger here, and Carson's going to extend his eyes here to hold the safety right here. Now we see this safety cut the ball right there. We see him trying to cut Alshon. So now we have a one-on-one matchup right there with Zach Ertz on a linebacker. And I haven't seen a linebacker in this league cover Zach Ertz yet. And again, this is a great example of the maturation again of our quarterback. This is what we call throw covered about to be uncovered. Right now, Zach Ertz is covered. That ball's gone, okay? We know that Zach Ertz is going to beat this linebacker with speed. So he's covered right now, but we're going to throw him uncovered to this area of the field for a huge completion.
You got to have trust from the quarterback and the tight end there that that play is going to work.
Absolutely.
And you can tell that the chemistry between those two guys is at an all-time high. Watching here, down here, close to the red zone area. You guys have been fantastic this season, being able to capitalize on touchdowns.
The last 3 or 4 weeks, we've been fantastic in the red zone. This is a new concept we installed this week. When we crossed the 30-yard line, we knew, again, I talked about middle of the field open, middle of the field close earlier. We knew that the Redskins want to be a middle of the field close team. So what we're trying to do here is we're going to work Zach on what we call a corner post. So he's going to work vertical with speed. Swearinger's got outside leverage right here. Just lean on him for a count. and take it right now to the post. Brent Celek here is going to run what we call a deep cross. So he's going to try to occupy this middle of the field safety so we can keep outside leverage right there on number 36. Nelson Aguilar is going to run what we call a wide route right here, and then we have a post right here by Alshon Jeffrey with the back coming now out into the flat here to try to get underneath to hold the flat defender underneath the corner post. Now, that being said, ball snapped. We want to hold the linebackers for a click with the play action. And again, look at vertical with speed. Look at Brent Celek and look at Zach Ertz get vertical with speed. Swearinger takes the bait right there, biting out. And now all we have to do is we call this a faith throw in the red zone. We have to have faith that Zach is going to cross the face of this defender because we can't go behind him. He has to cross the face of that defender right there. And Zach does a great job of understanding and not losing his leverage. And again, as soon as he comes out of that break, look at Carson. That ball's about to be thrown, covered, about to be uncovered, and we have a nice completion right there.
Great job going up and getting that ball, knowing that he might take a big hit there. Zach, you just don't see him drop very many balls. Let me watch this play down here in the end zone. Now, we watched Carson pre-snap. A lot's been made about the stuff he's doing before the ball is snapped. He certainly seems to recognize something that he wants to take advantage of with the Redskins defense.
Absolutely. This is another new concept we had put in for this week for them because we knew we were going to get a little bit of outside leverage here down here in the red zone with middle of the field closed. So the first thing we were going to do is assess in this play is if we think we're going to get outside leverage on the second receiver, we had a certain play called. Okay, what's going to happen here is Zach Ertz is going to work vertical and try to take two. He's going to try to get the eyes of the safety here and wall the free safety there. So we call that he's going to be a take two deep cross. Nelson now is going to run what we call a stutter post. So he's going to try to widen his defender right now and attack this area of the field right here. Torrey Smith's going to have a 5-yard pirate route right here. Corner route by Alshon Jeffrey. And then the back's going to come across right out here into the flat. As the play goes on here, Carson's changing the play just like we thought. We're going to get head up to outside leverage there on number two. We get buzzed to the flat right there. Zach does a great job of just holding the inside hook player for one count to open up this area of the field. And then again, look at how he affects the free safety here so he can't get over here to Nelson Aguilar. Just holds him for a count. And this is red zone football right here. We talk about red zone mindset all the time with the quarterbacks, okay? We talk about throws are face mask or higher. You're going to see this throw face mask or higher. We talk about touchdown, check down. Well, we're going to trust our guys to throw the ball in the end zone, but if it's not there, we're going to check the ball down. The least defended part of the field is the back of the end zone. So all those things come into play, what we talk about all the time, every week in our quarterback meeting room, of quarterback red zone mindset.